This summer, a total solar eclipse will cross the United States from coast to coast for the first time in a century. Thousands of people are flocking to the path of totality, the area where it will be possible to see the moon entirely cover up the sun. There will be music festivals and huge crowds. A Kentucky town even rebranded itself as Eclipseville. But what can eclipses actually teach us about our place in the solar system? People have tracked eclipses since the dawn of civilization. Many cultures thought they were bad omens and developed all kinds of myths to explain them. In ancient China, people believed a solar eclipse occurred when a sky dragon devoured the sun, and their word for eclipse came from the word to eat. In West Africa, some people believed eclipses happened when the sun and moon were fighting, and viewed the event as a time to resolve old feuds. By the early Renaissance, astronomers began to investigate the science behind eclipses. Nicolaus Copernicus saw four solar eclipses in his lifetime. His observations through a camera obscura helped him develop the theory that the sun was at the center of the solar system, not the Earth. In the 19th century, new large telescopes led to the discovery of Uranus and Neptune, and astronomy itself became more popular. The growth of railroads made it easier for people to travel to experience eclipses. During an eclipse in 1868, French astronomer Pierre Janssen used a newly designed instrument called a spectroscope to observe the sun's wispy atmosphere called the corona, which is only visible during a solar eclipse. Through the spectroscope, he saw light divided into each color of the rainbow, but he also saw a bright yellow line in the corona's spectrum that couldn't be explained. Astronomers later identified it as a new element and named it helium, after helios, the Greek word for sun. Now we know that it's the second most common substance in the universe. An eclipse even helped prove Einstein's theory of relativity, which held that gravity could warp space and time. In the year 1919, British astronomer Sir Arthur Eddington used a total eclipse to observe a star cluster behind the sun, called Hyades. He saw that the light coming off the stars was warped by the gravitational pull of the sun, just as Einstein had predicted. Like Sir Eddington before them, scientists today are planning dozens of experiments that can only be done during a total solar eclipse. The few minutes under the moon's shadow gives NASA the chance to study the sun's corona and its magnetic field. One team will send hundreds of helium balloons into the sky to study how Earth's atmosphere responds to the dramatic drop in light. But for the casual stargazer, like their ancient counterparts, the eclipse is a chance to experience firsthand a piece of the cosmos. And if you can't make it to Eclipseville, Kentucky this time, don't worry, there's always 2024. This is You Are Here, a series by The Atlantic about the science behind everyday life. Let us know what topics you want us to explore in the comments. I'm Leah Varjak. Thanks for watching.